We're back on Box 29 News, revealing news report. We get Box right on 29th Street for my beat the right out. What's wrong, Georgia boy? Chair Mackins in the backpackings and a fat gaddings and a couple rackets and all thatings. First off, come on, y'all. Like I'm trying to eat. Listen, we almost at 10,000 subscribers. That means we almost at 100,000 subscribers. That means even if you don't like me and you just coming to watch me, you still helping me, pushing me to get a Plackington, sending the bags and a lot of eggs of the sheer Mackington. Just trying to get a Plackington. You feel me? Niggas don't feel me. How? Breaking news. We at Mr. Aiden Water. If you do not know who Mr. Aiden Waters is, he's actually, absolutely, positively, 100% a 16-year-old driller, stubber, stormer, mover, pusher, or a 70 fixer. Torture her, camper her, sender her. I don't know what section of the city he's erring from at this moment. However, he is currently accused and charged with murder of YBC Duel. God damn, nigga, that was quick. That was quick than a sum. They caught you quicker than they caught the niggas that killed Biggie and Tupac, nigga. God damn, you 16, you done went and put in all this work to throw your life away, act a fool. Who your mom? I know she not proud of you. I know you embarrassed her. You got plaster all over Fox, Box, and all the news stations in the goddamn world, probably. Because YBC Duel was a high-profile case. Clearly, nigga, he caught your ass 5 days later. However, Mr. Aiden Waters got to be the stupidest, dumbest, retardest, maniacalist, diabolicalist nigga walking the face of the earth. Yeah, I know this nigga straight retard. Gotta be. Cause ain't no way you went from this to this. You feel me? Look at this, y'all. He was in the Olympics. Oh, look at the baby. Yeah, I wish he would have stayed on his path. However, this is the shit that I've been trying to get the kids to understand. Please do not stick your big toe in the street. You'll slide so far, nigga, you'll get a murder charge. Yeah, nigga, you could have been an Olympic gold medalist. Now you're a inmate. Yeah, welcome to CFCF, nigga. We got plenty of room for y'all stupid ass niggas. Yeah. However, Aiden decided to trade in his Olympic gold medals for some felony charges. Aiden, I'm not the smartest nigga in the world. I ain't never been to Harvard, Yale, Princeton, none of Mizzou. I'm just saying, that's not the smartest thing in the world to do. And you're going to regret that real soon. However, nigga, you was on the cover of ESPN? Nigga, you know what I mean? Is this Photoshop? I hope it's not Photoshopped and they playing in my face. I'm going to have to look this up. However, if you was on the cover of ESPN and it's not one of them little make my kid feel good shit, you got to be the most embarrassing kid in the world, nigga. Ain't no way. Ain't no way you could have been something decided to run your ass to the streets. And then when you get put your ass in jail and they slap the right out of your stupid ass. Nobody's going to have nothing for you. We're going to forget about you next year, Aiden. You know how many people got it? Did you do this for rec? Did you even know, dude? Let's start there. You 16. He was 25. Did you even know him? What you knew the person that he was dissing? What happened? Like, who told? This is why I love the streets. Niggas think the streets not going to talk and tell. The streets is tattletales, nigga. Yeah, they telling like a motherfucker. So, I can't wait till we find out who told I know we better not find out that you told in a rap or some stupid shit like that. However, over here we have the article. Walmart Dyslexia says a 16-year-old has been charged with killing West Philadelphia gang leader YBC Duel and shooting four others. Oh my God. We got a little Amin Hurst. Oh no, nigga, we don't play with Amin Hurst's. You want to act like Amin Hurst? We going to slap you like Amin Hurst. You feel me? Amin didn't get slapped yet. I just hope he gets slapped far as hell too. However, I'm pretty sure y'all seen this article on the internet. And I'm also pretty sure that y'all didn't read it. Yeah, niggas do not like to read. So, far my dyslexia says a 16-year-old has been charged with murder in the high-profile killing of a West Philadelphia gang leader and rapper. One of two killings and three shootings police say he committed across North Philadelphia last month. Aiden Waters, who officials said is affiliated with a street group, based out of the Island section of the city, is accused of killing two people and attempting to seriously injure or kill eight others within just 5 days in August, according to court records. Who kid is this? This cannot absolutely positively be, not be the same nigga on that ESPN show. That gotta be a fake cover or something. Got to be. You not gonna convince me that a nigga who almost was something turned out to be a diabolical piece of nothing. Gotta be Photoshop. Among those police say he killed is Abdul Vicks, a 25-year-old rapper and the head of a West Philadelphia-based gang known as the Young Bag Chasers, or YBC. Vicks, better known as YBC Duel, was killed in a drive-by shooting in Ollie on August 23rd. Police said that Vicks had just picked up a friend and was driving down the 5500 block of North Fairhill Street around 3:30 p.m. As he slowed at a stoplight, a white car, almost identical, probably the exact same make and model of the car, which police said had been following Vicks for a few minutes, drove up alongside and two passengers fired multiple rounds into the vehicle before speeding off. Vicks was struck multiple times in the chest and hand. His friend, in a panic, drove back to his house on North 6th Street and then, with the help of his uncle, rushed Vicks to Einstein Medical Center. He died just before 4 p.m. How would they link Waters to Vicks' killing? Surveillance footage, fingerprints, ballistic evidence, and jail calls proved crucial to identifying suspects according to the affidavit of probable cause for Waters' arrest. The night Vicks was killed, police said they recovered shooter's getaway car on the 6900 block of North 15th Street. The car, which had been stolen and shelled him a week earlier, had been burned, but detectives recovered ballistic evidence inside, as well as a series of fingerprints along the doors, the affidavit says. These niggas out here touching the car up. Had the car for a week. They probably, God, they didn't even burn the car properly. This is the shit. I be trying to understand. Y'all niggas at least got to be good criminals. Y'all can't even burn the car properly where you left fingerprints? Nigga, you could have went to the car wash first. Y'all could have absolutely positively went to the car wash first and then burned the car up and had better chances of, you feel me? However, detectives also recovered video footage of the getaway car and tracked it to a rear alleyway of a house on the 1700 block of 68th Street where Waters lives, according to the affidavit. Video shows a young man police believe to be Waters get out of the car and attempt to cover his face before going inside the home. Investigators are still working to identify the two other people they say believe were involved in Vic's killing. Waters' alleged crime spree. Waters' crime spree began about a week earlier, according to the affidavit, when he paid a friend $100 to steal a car from him and shelter him. That car, the white Kia Sportage, was later used as the getaway car in a gunpoint robbery outside a live casino on August 17th. And then, days later in the killing of Vicks, the records say, According to the documents, the two other shootings Waters has been charged with unfolded this way. Around 9:50 p.m. on August 18th, he opened fire on two people on the 500 block of Centenary Street in Longcrest. A 43-year-old man was struck in the abdomen and a 14-year-old was shot in the leg. Both survived. Then just hours later, around 2:30 a.m. on August 19, police say Waters, with at least one other person, fired more than a dozen rounds into a car full of teens on a 200 block of East Duncannon Street. Two 16-year-olds were shot, including Marquise Saunders, who was struck in the head and killed. Around 4 a.m., police recovered the shooter's getaway car, a gray Hyundai Sonata, on the 6500 block of North 10th Street. Investigators were able to determine that a cell phone had connected to the car and downloaded a data associated with the phone, said Assistant District Attorney Sidney Pope, who was prosecuting the case. Oh my God. Y'all niggas that linked the Bluetooth. Now the Bluetooth is connected to your cell phone data and then got your stupid ass. I love when y'all don't know what's going on. Anything you, in that way, Pope said they discovered a series of video calls between Waters and friends who were in jail. During the calls on August 20th, Waters discussed the series of crimes using cold words like scrimmage to describe the shooting and slam dunk to reference a homicide as if it was a basketball game, according to the affidavit. Oh, man, they just did it. Slang talk, slang talk, slang talk. And today, in Slang Talk, we have scrimmage and slam dunk. If you hear your kid saying anything about a scrimmage or a slam dunk, they are referring to shootings and homicides. Please be on the listen and the lookout for all scrimmages and slam dunks because they absolutely positively do not have no basketball meaning. These kids don't even go to the NBA. You feel me? However, anything you. There were two different scrimmages in one day, Waters told his friend, according to the affidavit. There were two different scrimmages in one day, Waters told his friend, according to the affidavit. One slam dunk and one went in and out. For those crimes, Waters had been charged with murder, arson, causing catastrophe, conspiracy, and gun crimes. He also faces 8 counts of attempted murder for the 3 people who were shot and survived, and for the 4 other teens who were in the car during the Duncannon Street shooting but were not shot. And y'all better not offer that nigga no less than 75 years. You feel me? That's what we want to start at, 75. You want to say this deal was 75 years? No? Cool. The next joint coming at which was 90. You feel me? However, since 2 guns was in Waters' home, police searched Waters' home on August 31st and recovered 2 guns, according to the affidavit. Like, who is his parents? Like, y'all don't even know where your kid is at in the middle of the night shooting people up. In the daytime shooting people up. Guns in the crib. What type of parents are y'all? Y'all don't know what y'all kid doing? He that good around y'all? He got the sheet pulled over your head that good? That's crazy. Anything you on Waters' bed, police found a 10mm handgun with a red switch, an attachment that turns a gun into an automatic weapon, as well as a laser pointer, extended magazine, and various other accessories, according to the records. In Waters' basement, police recovered a 9mm Glock that had been reported stolen, Pope said. A ballistic test of that gun, Pope said, matched the cartridge casing from the scene of the Vicks killing and the 2 other shootings. Oh my God! You stupid, dumb, retarded, inconsiderate, diabolical, maniacal, astronomical idiots. Not only did you probably have the most high-profile killing in the city in a while, you kept the gun? You should have just motherfucking stayed in the car that you left the fingerprints on, nigga. You should just sat in the car with the pistol, chilling, waiting for them to come get you. Y'all here? Oh, okay, I'll wait for y'all like a motherfucker. You kept the gun, left the fingerprints on the car, nigga. You had 2 guns. Why would you keep the gun that killed YBC duel, knowing, knowing they're looking for your ass. Nigga, they don't care if it's YBC duel. Nigga, if you kill somebody, you're going to prison. I don't think y'all understand that. And to you, Assistant District Attorney William Fritz urged parents to search their kids' belongings for weapons. What's happening is abnormal, he said. Get those guns out of the house. Waters remains in custody, held without a bail after being arraigned early Friday morning. He needs to be charged as an adult. I don't want to care that he didn't have the right chromosomes or his brain was underdeveloped. It wasn't underdeveloped enough to not pull that switch, that fa-fa. Yeah, it wasn't that underdeveloped, nigga. He know exactly. When he pointed that thing and said, brr, he knew that happened. I never even shot one of them guns. And I shot guns, but none of them never. When I shot guns, last time I shot guns, every time I pressed the joint, boom, a bullet had to come out. Boom, boom. They should go ahead, brr, 100 bullets. He knew that was going to happen, though. So I don't want to hear nobody. He didn't know a human brain don't fully develop. Well, let that shit develop in prison, nigga. Anything, why did Waters kill Vicks? Waters is affiliated with a gang known as Fast Break. That's why he was talking in basketball terms. However, now we have the Fast Breakers. He erring from that section. We looking for y'all now. Whoever part of the Fast Break crew, nigga, we coming for you. We going to get y'all niggas right subbed in the prison. We subbing y'all right in the prison. And you, Pope said, which is a lesser known group of teens based in the island section of the city. Members are connected to and considered to be little brothers of a more well-known crew, M24, affiliated with the area of Masher to 4th Streets in Alleyne. Please. This is the shit that I've been trying to understand. He probably didn't even know, dude. He probably didn't get no money off this. He probably don't have a clue who dude was this and that nigga probably did. That dude was this and you probably never even met him. Remember, you 16. You just hopped off the porch last week and you went crazy. Yeah, you went crazy. You went crazier than I mean hers, nigga. Yeah, so we got room enough for both of y'all. However, I hope it was worth it, nigga. And to you, we're putting a full court press on Fast Break. District Attorney Larry Kraft said. Shout out Ogallala. He do not play. When y'all want to act stupid, he act stupid and goofy right with y'all niggas. I appreciate that from him. However, down here says the charges come just 2 weeks after Vicks was killed. A death that shocked many, from young people who listen to his music to law enforcement who had been monitoring his whereabouts. As a founding member of YBC, a gang based out of the Mantua section of West Philadelphia, Vicks was a main figure in the Philadelphia drill rap scene. His songs, many of which have racked up millions of views on YouTube, were known for their vulgar references to shootings and crimes. And his lyrics frequently mocked the people. Police say YBC members have killed. Because of this, he also went by the nickname Mr. Disrespectful. He had made enemies of basically everybody in the city, said Pope, the prosecutor. Our suspect pool was fairly large. She said there was little to share about why Fast Break or Waters wanted Vicks dead or what rivalry, if any, they had with YBC. It comes back to the driver of many of the shootings between young people in the city, she said. They were looking for notoriety, also known as clout. And I started saying this. Y'all know I didn't pre-read that long ass. I know you didn't do this for clout, nigga. I know you didn't. Come on. You killed dude for clout. You don't even know him now. You don't have no life. I hope they give you life, nigga. Let's see if they got some more stuff down here. No, that's it. So, damn. Dumb boy, if you did that for clout, I know you ain't the smartest nigga in the world. I know when you had them goddamn things around your neck, them gold medals, that ain't mean nothing. That was chocolate bars inside them joints. Yeah, that was chocolate bars and goddamn Photoshop, nigga. You wasn't never worth nothing. However, over here we have my sister coming in. I'ma just send it over to my sister coming to give you official report. Say the way, please. get it to you.
And right now, a 16-year-old boy is charged with the murder of a Philadelphia rapper. That shooting happened last month in Alney. The 25-year-old rapper Abdul Vicks, also known as YBC Duel, was killed. District Attorney Larry Krasner announcing those charges today.
He also says the teen suspect is connected to several other shootings. Jeff, what can you tell us?
Well, I can tell you that the country and this region appears to have a problem with young victims and young people shooting guns. Listen, prosecutors with the district attorney's office tonight are urging parents in the city of Philadelphia to search the rooms of their children to find guns there and call the police to have them taken away. This, as you folks have reported.
No, have the kid taken away. Don't have the gun taken away. Take the gun, too. Take the kid, one. You feel me? Anything.
As he charges a 16-year-old with double murder. In a light rain near a basketball court in Alney, DA Larry Krasner reports he's charged a 16-year-old with the killing of two and the wounding of others as part of a shooting group known as Fast Break.
A small group of young people in the city of Philadelphia made a decision to hold a gun, to point a gun at another human being and pull the trigger.
The alleged teenage shooter is Aiden Waters. The DA says he's the killer of 25-year-old rapper Abdul.
Yo, they didn't even say alleged. He's the killer. Yeah, nigga, you got the gun. You left the goddamn car with the fingerprints on it. I hope you don't tell, nigga. Y'all better not hope he don't tell. You feel me? I better hope he don't tell. Anything.
Vicks in a shooting on the 5500 block of North Fairhill Street in late August. Investigators report they've linked Waters to a wave of shootings in Philadelphia last month, along with the murder counts. He faces attempted murder, aggravated assault, and gun charges.
It's called clout chasing, is what we call it. It's what everyone calls it, I guess. You're looking for notoriety. You're looking to make a name for yourself.
Prosecutors say the guns used in the killings were illegal and one had a switch installed, allowing for multiple shots with one squeeze of the trigger. Prosecutors are urging parents to search their children's rooms for guns.
Recover the firearms that are in the homes, in the basements, under the rafters. Call the police. Tell them you found a gun in your house.
At 16, Waters...
And tell them you found a kid in your house, too. Anything you...
is likely to spend much of his life in prison if convicted, while a city council member calls for early intervention for teens like him.
We need to find ways to get a hold of these clout chasers, these young people who are oftentimes doing things.
Listen, hold on, right? This is how you know it's crazy, right? They don't even usually show underage suspects. They zooming in, showing him 200-400 times, nigga, zooming in some more, nigga. They going to show, make an example out of somebody. Anything.
Just to be noticed.
Once again, a 16-year-old charged with double murder in this case. The district attorney calls this a rapid response to violent crime. The alleged shooting occurred just last month. In the meantime, they are urging parents to help them with their efforts. Live in Olney, I'm Jeff.
Thank you, Jeff. Parents, go in your kids' room, find the guns, call the police on your kids. Why is that so hard? I promise you, I call the cops on my young. Yeah. He right. He's late. Come get him. I'm gonna make him kick the door. Woo! He getting the authentic goddamn arrest too. He ain't getting the easy walk away. You getting the authentic joint. Boo! Get on the ground. Guns blazing, flashlights on, and everything. Yeah, they probably have a dog with him and everything. If I catch a gun in my crib, you feel me? Because it start with us. Like how we just want. His mom and his dad were like, that wasn't his. He wasn't doing that. Yes, he was, man. Shut up. It was him. He left his fingerprints on the gun and the car, and the gun was in your house. You feel me? And he connected the Bluetooth, miss. What you saying now? Go ahead, defend your son now. And I hope your homies, I hope they got a lawyer for you. However, we just had people here the other day who homies didn't even have commissary for them. That's how it go. You feel me? So thank you for throwing your life away, Aiden. You probably could have been more if you would have focused and win. Yeah, you could have focused. You probably would have won if you was winning. You probably was focused. Shout out to the Focus and Win shirt. Shout out to my man over at Focus and Win. If you do want a Focus and Win shirt, please go to Focus and Win on Instagram. You can't miss it. It's just Focus and Win. You feel me? However, if Aiden would have focused, he probably would have won a real gold medal instead of them chocolate bars. Other than that, kids, please make sure you're probably a stupid dumb retarded motherfucker. Dream something some move, push your probably not gonna make any life. Probably have no dreams, no goals, no aspirations. Probably gonna be embarrassing your parents. Probably gonna be throwing your life away for stupid shit. Cause this is the show that you make, not sure it makes them actually the worst in the world. Box 29 News, Rippling News Report. Right on 29, she's my beat. The fuck? What the fuck is wrong with you? Don't play with me, don't play with me, don't play with me.